This is the world's largest sugar cube challenge.
Here we go.
My full-time job is eating ridiculous amounts of food.
It was a terrible, terrible idea.
For my YouTube audience.
It's pizza time.
It's McDonald's time, people.
8 different kinds of pasta.
There is a lot of pressure to constantly be more extreme.
For every pound that I weigh, I have to eat 1 donut.
You're ingesting pounds of food. How unhealthy. You can't just sit on a couch and do this and expect to be healthy.
I have food up on this pedestal, and it's just like everything is about food.
I'd been called fat, but no one's ever been like, you're obese. You know, when you hear that as a kid, whoa, that kept playing on repeat. A big part of getting over an eating disorder is to actually expose yourself to what is causing you to have irrational fears. Food challenges were kind of just a way for me to just flip the light switch on.
What is going on, everybody? Eric the Electric coming to you guys again with another video.
Today, I'm gonna be talking about the fear of fat.
There's this strive to be this muscular man because that's what's gonna give you the most confidence. It actually ended up going the opposite way. It is a lifelong battle that you're going to have to face.
So we got a long ways to go.
I'm going to be obsessed with fixing this. I remember thinking, is that really something I like should be doing? Okay, so there I am. So right now I have 1.77 million subscribers. My most popular video is the 100,000 calorie challenge. That one's at 14 million views. I did that 3 years ago.
Man, I'm hungry. Just gotta have this casual dinner tonight.
That's the one that pretty much everyone knows me for.
8 hours in, and I know I've eaten way too much already.
My name is Eric Lampkin, otherwise known as Eric the Electric.
What is going on, folks? Eric the Electric coming back to you guys again. My electric empire. Another video.
My full-time job is eating ridiculous amounts of food for my YouTube audience. That's what people see as my specialty, is like being able to eat insane amounts of calories. 1 week it could be $100 worth of McDonald's. And the other week it could be 1,000 M&Ms or everything inside of a vending machine. You know, I like to keep it, you know, constantly creative and different with ideas. I edit everything myself, I film everything myself, I do all my thumbnails, and YouTube's really cool because it's like, that's what you can do.
I've never done something this gross and disgusting, but also monumental in my entire life.
My actual first YouTube channel started as a fitness channel. I was really big into lifting and powerlifting.
Things are gonna be busting ass in the gym, training hard.
I shifted my focus from powerlifting to doing endurance type of training, which is long hours on the bike. That's actually something I do pretty much every day. It kind of goes well with what I do for my food stuff because it keeps me healthy. When I graduated in 2017, I wasn't really sure yet if I could actually make a living doing what I did. My passions, they were mainly around my bike, but I didn't want to work in a bike shop for the rest of my life. I had friends that were making sizable like incomes on YouTube, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna try it. And from that point forward, it was just every single week I've posted a food challenge, and I haven't missed a week since then. Before every challenge, I always just try to make sure I have my run, my bike ride, and a weightlifting session. When you look at a lot of competitive eaters, you'll usually see either someone that is like me, or you'll see someone extremely overweight. It's been a very big belief of mine over, you know, the past few years that I've been doing this, just to show people that you can eat these unhealthy foods and you can still have a healthy life. It all kind of boils down to the person. The conventional way of looking at something like this is, wow, how unhealthy. That's gonna give you diabetes, you're gonna have high cholesterol, how terrible. But I take my health very seriously.
All right, let's see what we ordered. Free T4, hemoglobin, DHEA, sulfate, cortisol. Very happy that we got cortisol, thyroid stimulant.
I order all of my own blood work and do all of my own health. I manage all of that myself. Every time that I have seen my doctor for a physical and I get blood work back, my triglycerides are always super low. He's always just like, wow, your cholesterol is great. he, you know, is always really impressed.
People that have to draw blood, love him.
Now I'm going to start dinner. The day before a food challenge, I typically don't do anything drastically different. I'll mostly bump up my salad that I have the night before and make it really, really big. Or sometimes I have two really giant salads to really just get my stomach capacity higher.
How much of this can I have?
You can have as much as you'd like.
Yeah, so I compete, so I do bikini competitions, and so diet in the gym, and so you watch a lot of food channels like Food Network. So I started following him. A huge appeal to his videos is that when you're on like a very, very strict diet, like you're hungry, and you want to live vicariously through somebody who's eating all the foods that you're craving, and all the sweet desserts were my favorite challenges. I was a total fan. Crazy part was is that when I came out to LA to do the food challenge with him, we had never, I didn't know if he was dating somebody, like low key. I wouldn't have been surprised if he was gay. Like, I didn't know, like I had no idea.
Hey, what's up?
What is this?
Hi, my name is Christy Higgs.
Fitness extraordinaire by day, monster eater by night.
Cheers, cheers.
It's funny because like in the middle of the challenge, I had been thinking about kind of like asking her, can I make this like a date? Can I call this the food challenge date?
I had no idea he was gonna drop that on me at all.
I have never had confidence with women in my life. That was very hard for me to do. So, that's how that all happened.
Yeah. What are you filming tomorrow?
I'm gonna be doing a clash of the calories between McDonald's and Burger King.
McDonald's videos always do really well, so that'll be good. How many calories do you think you're gonna do?
Probably a lot.
That'll be a good challenge.
Yeah. I'm excited for it.
Do you have a big training day tomorrow?
Yeah, it's going to be, I'm going to do a bike ride in the morning and a run. And then I'm going to go lift after that.
So I pretty much won't see you all
you
day.
You most likely won't see me.
Okay.
I'll be doing my thing.
It'll just be me and you. Yeah.
Paul.
My chicken's really good.
There's quite a few misconceptions that people have about me and my videos. I'm of a belief that I'd like to just be as transparent with people. I also just want people to know that I understand what I'm doing fully and I have control over it. A lot of people would look at what I do as a pretty extreme thing, and growing up I've realized that I'm a person that likes working at a goal and getting to the end product because the feeling of accomplishment is so rewarding. But if I fail to do something, I usually tend to take that pretty hard.
Let's see here. Maybe.
Are these all just me?
They're all just you.
Oh, I didn't know I had my own albums. I was a big baby. I was 9 pounds, 9 ounces. I was huge.
Yes, he was.
And a giant head. I still have a giant head.
Every morning before you went to school, you had to have pancakes loaded up with peanut butter, chocolate chips, the syrup, or he'd have
that was
the
just
cereal.
A phase. I mean, I was like, as soon as I got to be in like 5th, 6th, 7th grade, I was over it.
I don't think I have any of those because that was like in his teens. He was living with his dad and me. So we had, you know, it was a little more difficult to get photos.
Yeah, I feel like the photo phase kind of stopped at like 5 or 6.
Mm-hmm.
And then the divorce happened when I was like 7.
6. You were almost turning 6.
Yeah. So all of the photos kind of just like, nope, no more.
Yeah.
When all of this happened, I started just wanting to spend a lot of time alone. I would sit in my room and play video games and I would eat. Over time, that just led to me having a weight issue. And so the last thing I wanted to do was take photos. I was diagnosed with gynecomastia, and it's actually an enlargement of breast tissue, basically man boobs. The end of freshman year, I believe I was trying to try out for the basketball team, and so my dad needed to take me in to get a physical. And that was the first time I'd seen a doctor, like in probably years. And so they did blood work, and the doctor, she looks up at a chart, and she goes, he's actually obese. And so I heard her say the word obese. That kept playing on repeat. I'd been called fat, I'd been called, you know, a bunch of names, but no one's ever been like, you're obese. Like, I remember just crying. I was so embarrassed about it. From that moment forward, my new shift and my entire focus became, I'm going to be obsessed with fixing this.
Eric, you loved your community, you guys, with another video again.
I woke up one morning and I was like, you know what? I'm actually just going to go on a run. And then I started tracking my calories. And then I was weighing myself. I wasn't 200 pounds anymore. I was getting positive reinforcement from, you know, my parents and the people that were around me. And so that just became like second nature. Like, that was what I did. You know, that's pretty much how everything started before it started to turn in a different direction. When I lost all of my weight, it made my gynecomastia actually worse because that's the only thing that stood out. So up until I got surgery for it, was I constantly fixated on this issue. More weight loss, just all I could focus on was that, to try to fix that, and it just ended up making it worse. And by the time I had spent years trying to lose more weight to fix this, I was already in this cycle of just trying to just get thinner and thinner and thinner and thinner. I was diagnosed with anorexia when I was 16 years old. Of people who are diagnosed with an eating disorder, 1 in 3 will be men. It's a taboo thing. A lot of men feel like it's an unmasculine thing to be able to talk about eating issues, body image. My dad just basically had an ultimatum with me, and he was just like, well, you need to go to this facility that's here in San Diego. They'll, you know, monitor every meal. You need to go do this for the entire summer.
I still got a long ways to go.
A lot of my audience are younger kids, and I mean, I'll have them come up to me, and there's this need to strive to be this jacked, you know, muscular man, because that's what the girls want. That's what's gonna give you the most confidence. That's what I thought. It actually ended up going the opposite way.
I have food up on this pedestal, and it's just like, everything is about food.
Thank you. Perfect, thanks so much. Can I?
The card.
Oh, did I forget my card? Thank you. Could I grab one more bag from you?
One more bag?
Yeah, thank you.
More bags, more better.
Thanks so much. Sorry for the big order. Have a good day. Now, it's time to head to the next destination, McDonald's.
Tonight, I'm filming a clash of the calories between Burger King and McDonald's. Ooh, no. That is a long line. Good thing McDonald's is efficient. It's not like I just like went from being this guy with an eating disorder and then just going and doing a food challenge. I'm like, great, cool, that was easy. It's totally not like that at all. There was a few moments where I was really thinking about, is that really something I like should be doing?
Hi there, I'd like 2 Big Macs, please. 2 quarter pounders with cheese, 3 medium fries, 1 large Diet Coke, 1 20 piece nugget, 1 M&M McFlurry, please. 3 apple pies, an apple pie McFlurry. Can you do all of your sauces?
I had just gotten out of a clinical setting where I was being told like, this is okay, this is not okay. With food, with exercise, I expected to feel like pretty guilty.
Should've hit him with the, is that enough for one person?
Yeah. 58. I realized that like I didn't feel like horrible. I was able to really move past it.
Thank you.
But in my eyes, you can abstain from alcohol, drug use, whatever it is, and you can recover from those things. When it comes to eating disorders, I'm of the belief that it is a lifelong battle that you're going to have to face.
This is going to be absolutely delicious. I am so excited to get into all this fast food. Everyone, after the last calorie clash, I have been getting so many requests, all right? But now, there's
quite a few misconceptions that people have about me and my videos. The first one is that I have a really easy time and really easy job.
No, dude, I can't play with you right now. Go.
If you're new to the calorie clash series, McDonald's, which is because can't even talk.
There is a lot of pressure to constantly be more extreme. Every YouTuber has to deal with that because once you start doing something, you can't keep doing that thing unless you go bigger. unless you get more creative, unless you get crazier.
A lot of YouTubers will think like the title is like the first thing that people see. I think people notice the thumbnail first. So I tend to spend the most time on actually like taking the thumbnail photo.
This is my thumbnail shirt. I have it only for thumbnails.
Alright, everybody, so the first round is going to be the nugget round because McDonald's has amazing nuggets. They're famous for their chicken nuggets, but Burger King also has chicken fries. So let's get into it. 3, 2, and 1. Boom.
I've never really been super competitive against other people. I've always been really competitive with myself.
That's fire.
A big part of getting over an eating disorder is to actually expose yourself to what is causing you to have irrational fears.
The sweet and sour sauce is great, but what if we put some wow sauce? Let's see how it's gonna taste. Whew! Everyone, we got our first W.
Oh, W.
Food challenges were kind of just another way for me to just be like, oh, yeah, like it really is just food. It just helped me kind of flip the light switch on that it was really just a trivial thing.
All right, everybody. Well, I think the winner of the nugget round, it's got to be McDonald's nuggets. Absolutely amazing. Now, everybody, it's time for round number 2, the burger round.
If you're a subscriber of mine and you go through all of my videos, I'm transparent with what I need to do in order to do this, what my body does, literally done my blood work before the food challenge and after the food challenge. Obviously pretty surprising to a lot of people to see a guy look like he was 9 months pregnant, you know, but I believe that that's incredibly important for people to see.
The Whopper is down. We gotta get to the McDonald's signature burgers right here, which are their quarter pounders.
So let's see what we got. Here we go.
I've eaten so much McDonald's and so much Burger King over my life. I know exactly how it's gonna make me feel burger by burger. I'm not like really getting close to full yet. Probably once I get towards the fries. Fries are really hard to get down.
I received a lot of criticism. A lot of people were telling me, you're making my eating disorder worse. You're glorifying binge eating, or you're promoting such an unhealthy message. But at the same time, that type of criticism was so very small compared to the positive messages that I got from people that were like, wow, I never knew this. This was a different side to you. And that made me realize that I cannot be responsible for how people perceive my videos. What people think and how people act, it's completely up to them.
I gotta give this round to McDonald's. McDonald's is leading the way right now. But everybody, we have 2 more rounds left. It's time for the fry round.
I don't think that everybody that watches me has an eating disorder, but I would say that out of the people that watch me, there is a very, 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 very small percentage of them that actually do have eating disorders. And these people are just watching a guy eat a lot of food because it's pretty ridiculous. I'm entertaining them. Certain points during food challenges where it's been like, I'm at 80% done and I feel a wall that just hit me like a freight train.
I feel like really burp, but I can't.
It can be, you know, me needing to poop. It's a pretty gross thing to think about, but like you're ingesting pounds of food. It's pushing down on your organs.
Now everyone, it's time for the round I'm most excited about. It's time for the dessert round.
I feel discomfort.
Strawberry shake soup. You know what, everybody? I think I'm just gonna call it there. Burger King is the winner tonight, everybody. Absolutely amazing, but I do wanna know down below right now what you guys prefer. Are you team Burger King or are you team McDonald's? Let me know down below in the comments. While you're down below in the comments, don't forget to hit that like button.
That's a wrap.
I got a decent sized food baby. Usual. Feels like I got a newborn child in there somewhere. How's it look? Expanded? Like I'm the epitome of health.
A lot of people that have eating disorders will, you know, think that, oh, like if I go out and do a food challenge, it's gonna help me overcome all of my issues and all of my demons. And I've tried to help people understand that that's not what's going to happen at all.
So who won?
Burger King won.
I told you, did I not tell you it was gonna win last night?
Yeah.
How's your stomach?
It's good.
What's your full level?
I don't know, like 70%, 80%. You got a massive food baby. They saw it.
Therapy definitely had a very big role in me being able to like be aware that I was having irrational thoughts around food.
We're gonna eat dinner.
Enjoy.
So what are your plans now?
Just hang out.
Just gonna chill?
Yep.
All right.
Once I understood that I wasn't going to blow up into what I once was, it's actually gonna take months, if not years, of overeating constantly and zero exercise for me to become the chunky kid I was. People seem to think that I do what I do so that I don't gain weight, and it's really just I do what I do because it makes me feel good and I'm happy doing it. I knew those chicks weren't gonna sit well with me.
That's exactly what I asked them.
Oh. As soon as I laid down, I was like, nope. Oh, I'm good now.
You okay?
Yeah. Last time I've like had that happen was like, ice cream definitely is not good.
How are you feeling now?
good. I feel a lot better. A lot of people will openly say, I'm fully recovered. I never have any bad thoughts about food or myself or my body. If that's what drives them, they feel good that way, then great. But I'm of the belief that it is a lifelong battle that you're going to have to face, and no one can define that except you.
That is a lot of Chinese food. Good thing I'm very, very hungry.
It's liquid wasabi. Oh my. My sinuses.